Congratulations, Larry Young, the greatest senator to ever have lived, the number one talk show host in America.
Congratulations, Senator Young. Well deserved. Congratulations, Larry Young.
What's so important?
Congratulations, Larry. Thank you for all that you've done for Baltimore City.
We weren't producing.
Anniversary.
Congratulations, Larry Young. You're the best.
The thought of you helps me carry on when I feel all hope is gone. I see the world with brand new eyes. Your love has made me realize my future looks bright to me. Oh, because you
to the community and to all that you were able to accomplish. Dr. Hughes, thank you so much for giving our community this talent so that we could be better informed and more effective in our community engagement. But you see, I go back to Larry long before that. I go back to the days when he was really a young legislator. Bill Ferguson knows that when you're responsible for the Senate or the House, Adrian Jennings knows this, you got to put together a real team in order to be able to produce. And I was so fortunate because I had a talented young state delegate who was passionate about providing health care to communities that did not have access to health care. And yes, I appointed Larry. He was the first black chair of a standing committee in the House of Delegates. I was proud to be able to make that appointment. But let me tell you this. Larry Young helped me to become the speaker that I was. and gave me a chance to run for the Congress in the United States.
I would like you, in my opinion, America's conscience, a gentleman who, because of his being on television, causes me to miss more Raven games on a Sunday than I can care to mention. But he has Politics Nation, and so if he has Politics Nation, I'll be listening to it on Saturdays and Sundays. In addition to that, his program came right behind mine on Radio 1, his 7 p.m. radio show. Family, we have tonight, I call him America's conscience, the Reverend Al Sharpton.
Thank you, thank you. Give Larry another big hand. When this program was being put together and the date was given to our office, they said that there was a conflict. I said, whatever the conflict was, I had to be here. Late early this morning, I got a call. President Biden's in Syracuse, and there's an emergency you hear about on the news that they want everybody to come to. I'm gonna deny him before the week was over. And when the dinner was over, the Bible said he got up and took his loins and removed his garments. And he got down and they said, what are you doing, Master? He says, I want to wash your feet. And they said, you can't wash our feet. He said, no, I'm teaching you how to serve. Because unless you can humble yourself to wash the feet of each other, you can't serve and do what I want you to do. I want to set the example by washing your feet. But what was so amazing about that night, Miss Yu, that he washed their feet? If Jesus washed the feet of the man that would betray him, the reason I know he knew he'd betray him is he looked at Judas and said, do what you have to do and do it quickly. Larry Young has given a mic and served people that he knew betrayed him, that he knew backstabbed him, but he gave them a voice anyhow. He's operated in the spirit of Jesus to help those that do wrong to you. Because until you're big enough to understand that it is bigger than you, and it's not about who helped you, it's about who you help. And it's about doing what's right, even if you've been done wrong. You will not have the spirit of Christ. And this man has shown that spirit. And this man has been that example. That's why there's a bad rumor that went out. Somebody said that Larry got sick and they took one of Larry's legs and Larry can't walk no more. But that's not true. Because as long as I have 2 feet, Larry Young will be walking all over this country. Thank you, Larry, and God bless. Let me say this that is important for you to know. And you that listen to WOLB has heard me say it before. When I ran for president in 04, and when you run for president, you go for broke. I didn't have to go for broke because I was already broke. When I got finished, a guy came to me and said, I want you to do a radio show. You can make some money, we'll pay you. I signed a contract, and about a month later, I got a call from Kathy Hughes. Kathy Hughes said that I'm gonna start a syndicated show, Black Talk. Not gonna make me a lot of money, but I'm gonna pay you. Because we need to have a voice in the country, all over the country. I said, well, that's great, she says. I said, but I just signed a contract about a month ago. She said, all right.
I'll buy the contract. And I'm gonna put you on stations all over the country. That was 17 years ago. For 17 years, February 1st of next year, this woman has given me awards. I don't care about MSNBC. I didn't even know what MSNBC was when I went on Keeping It Real. We should never take the presence of Kathy Hughes for granted, because she gave Black America a megaphone. That's a friend. And Kathy Hughes picked him up and picked me up, and we gonna lift her up, and we not gonna shame her, because she never shamed us. Larry, I've tried to think of all the battles we've been in together, but I can't think of them.
Of a 17-vote elections that's not possible but for a Larry Young. And so everything we've done has been empowered in no small measure, my friend, by what you have done. But what I love, the pièce de résistance, the real beauty is that my friend isn't afraid to bring me on, ask the hard questions, hold me accountable, and yes, even send Johnny O a text and say, young man, you gotta meet me in Panera, we gotta talk about something. But I love you for it, we are better for it, and I just couldn't be more honored to call you a friend. Thank you for everything, congratulations.
I looked at Kathy and I said, oh, Kathy, you are the Lena Horne of communication. And that was not a joke. That was not, now, you know, I can't help it. I had a crush on her all these years. We're only a year apart, so we were right in that period of time. I just love you, and I love what you have done to revolutionize the ability of people to communicate and for people to be able to be made to feel special because somebody is listening. And so whether it's this station or any other station, that happens and it rings out in a very real kind of way. So aside from the fact that you're beautiful and kind, thank you for being a visionary. Because when you put him on the air, and Sharpton, and so many, many others, that was the start of a process that we're celebrating here in many respects tonight. She did it, and without her, it wouldn't have been done. Now, Larry and I go way back. 1978. Oh yeah, I was 29 going on 30.
Larry decided to stand here and say that we might be 11 days away from doing something special, but the reality is I know I can see higher because I know the shoulders that I'm standing on.
That's right.
I know who has provided that level of push, that level of support, and that level of validation. That we know that every space that we're moving into, we are moving into because those steps have been ordered and that work has been done. I'm thankful to also, again, before I tell a very brief, I'll be brief, I promise, but I also wanted to acknowledge the queen to my right as well, Kathy Hughes.
That's right.
Because it's important for y'all to know that one of my mom's first bosses was Kathy Hughes. That my mother, when she was coming up and aspiring in the entertainment industry, writer in the radio field, and when she was looking for a person in a space that was willing to give her an opportunity, not many opportunities were open and as open to an immigrant from Jamaica who just wanted a chance to be able to prove her value and prove her worth inside of the industry. And then somebody gave her an opportunity. Somebody saw her. Somebody gave her a chance. That person who gave her a chance is Miss Kathy Hughes.
So as you please, we can sail upon the breeze.
West Baltimore down because she went downstairs and went to all four radio stations and said, I will not, catch this, take blood money. She said to them, and they were offering her $500,000. She turned it down. She turned it down. And then, scared me a little bit. She said, don't bother, they put you away, guess what? I'll put a radio station out right there where you be, and you can do your show from there. I said, what kind of woman is this? Well, family, I just want you to know. And people came to me after this and said, after all, but you don't understand this. In every direction I have gone in the 25 years, I've been able to do so because I listened and I observed. And I've learned to listen to what she gives you because she has been through and she gives you all the vision you need. Has never ever turned me down when I asked her for advice and sometimes gave me advice before I asked for it.
Can we give our creator a big round of applause? Now, number one, Larry has fooled you all because this is not a retirement party, this is a reunion. And the purpose of us being here this evening is to say thank you in unity to a man who put this community, its citizens, its residents in front of everything else except his mom. The only thing more important to Larry Young than Baltimore, Maryland was his mother. I thank God this evening for the woman who brought him into the world. He did not give birth
knowing how to take care of his people. He is not coming to the world knowing that he had an obligation. She's the one who taught him what his responsibility was to be to his community and his people. Give his mother a round of applause.
Good time?
Oh yes, I did. I always have a good time.
I enjoyed myself immensely.
You had a good time?
I needed to be here.
And you are a singer from Germany?
I'm a singer. I'm from Baltimore, but I've been in Germany 25 years singing all over the country.
You like a miniature Eartha Kitt?
Yeah, maybe so, because I've worked with her too.